Thank you for logging on to WPTZ.com. I'm meteorologist Hayley LaPoint. So today we're beginning with a lot of cloud cover, temperatures a lot colder too, in the single digits in most locations, even a few spots down below zero. There are going to be some mountain snow flurries, especially by Mount Mansfield, along the western slopes of the Green Mountains, and into the Adirondacks. Mainly cloudy at noontime, but there will be some peaks of sunshine all through the afternoon as temperatures climb only into the low teens. This is going to be a cold, wintry day, and clearing skies by this evening, that will mean a very cold night tonight and early tomorrow morning. Here's the latest satellite and radar. You can see a couple little splotches of the white indicating at the mountain peaks along the greens and then also into the Adirondacks, some light snow on top. Generally speaking, we do have some low clouds hanging around, and those can contain a little bit of moisture, so you get those mountain snow flurries coming down. But the rest of us dry, high pressure, a huge area of it moving into the Ohio River Valley, and you can see that we barely have any clouds once you get off toward the west side of the high pressure, and eventually even the clouds over us now will begin to fade away during the overnight tonight, and especially tomorrow. That's when we'll see a lot of clear sky and a lot of sunshine during the day, of course. Keeping our eyes on the southeast, another storm system bringing some ice and snow to places in the southeast that just don't usually see that. It's another type of storm. Won't be as crippling for places like Atlanta, but still incredible to see snow that far south in Mississippi, in Alabama, and in northern Georgia, too. This is actually our storm system we will be tracking very closely as we get closer to the end of the week. But what's going to happen is, this is Futurecast, and you can keep your eye on the timestamp up here, that it's basically going to make a beeline for the ocean, the Atlantic, and then start a track up the north and east, right up the coastline during the next 24 hours or so. And it starts to gain more moisture and actually becomes a nor'easter. Now, the big question remains, how close to the coastline does this thing remain? Does it come inland at all? If it does, that would mean possibly some significant snowfall. At this point, though, it looks like we're just going to get a brushing glance, especially southern Vermont and eastern Vermont. That's where I'm expecting to see a little bit of snow. And there will be a hard cutoff where there is snow and where there isn't snow. So some of us may not see a thing from this system. It's going to be that much of a divide, and you can even see that here. This is about midnight on Friday, and the center of the storm right off the coast of Cape Cod. So if that wiggles a little bit, if it goes a little bit more inland, like right over the city of Boston, that's where this heavier snow band will then move farther inland and would mean significant snow for almost everybody. Here's what our thinking is. So far, it's looking like light accumulation. Champlain Valley, certainly when you get out into the St. Lawrence River Valley, very light. Light meaning an inch, maybe a couple inches, whereas this heavy blue area for all of eastern Vermont, southern Vermont, could be as much as 6 inches plus. So we will keep our eyes on it and let you know as we get closer in time and the forecast becomes a little bit clearer. 13 today, though. Good idea to bundle up, bring along your sunglasses. It's really bright when you get the sun on that fresh snow. Blend of clouds and sun today. And tonight will be a cold night, down below zero for everyone. 5 below Burlington, 6 below in Plattsburgh and in the Northeast Kingdom. And in the Adirondacks, easily double digits below zero. Here's the 5-day forecast plus 2. Tomorrow, sunny after a cold start, will recover to 20 degrees. Then warming into the 30s Thursday and Friday as that storm system passes by us. Saturday, another quick-moving storm system will bring some light snow showers. Travel may become a little bit slippery on Saturday because of that, but it won't be more than a couple inches with that quick-moving little storm. Sunday, the quiet of the two weekend days, temperatures cooler in the 20s, and we start out next week on President's Day with some sun, clouds, temperatures in the 20s. Thanks for logging on. Have a great day.